Our next guest is a professor of computer science at Notre Dame's College of Engineering who recently received a 5-year grant from the National Institutes of Health to study how parasites collectively control their hosts. Joining us now on Notre Dame Day is Dr. Danny Chen. Dr. Chen, welcome to Notre Dame Day.
Thank you.
Happy to have you here, my man.
Yeah,
so let's jump right into it. Honestly, Dr. Chen, when I think about a parasite controlling a host organism, I think of science fiction. I think of the movies. Tell us a little bit about your work and how that fits into reality.
Yeah, this is a very interesting project. Joined with a group of professors at Penn State University. In the project, we would like to study how ants are controlled by parasites to change their behavior. So this project is important in the sense that we want to understand large number of parasites. They control ants. For example, an ant infected by parasite will walk out the nets of the colony and then find an optimal position above the trail of the colony and attach itself to a leaf, and then the parasite will kill the ant. Then a stalk will grow out of the heads of the dead ants and spread fungus spores to other ants walking on the trail to infect those ants.
Wow.
So this is a project in which we want to develop computational model and method to understand the so-called social behavior of many tiny organisms.
All right, tiny organisms. And I understand that your intersection with this research is on developing algorithms to study parasites and hosts. Could you translate that for us? Like, how do algorithms help us understand nature in this way?
Yes, because this is about the study of collective biological systems. So in a collective biological system, you have a large number of tiny organisms, and they interact with their host to control the organism's behavior in a very different way. That is called complex manipulation. So in order to understand that, we need to develop algorithms to understand how the parasite interact with each other and interact with the host. Therefore, we need to develop computer vision algorithm to identify parasite and the host tissues and the distribution of parasite inside the body of the host and how they can form different patterns to achieve their manipulation. So algorithm tools are very important.
Yeah, no doubt. And Dr. Chen, can you tell our viewers how an education in computer science can have such wide-reaching applications?
Yes. I always believe that computer science education can really empower students. It helps students to develop essential skills for computations, modelings, and analysis to solve important problems in real life and practical applications. So when I teach the undergraduate algorithm course, I constantly show students that they can use computer science techniques and knowledge to solve meaningful problems and can even save life, like help treat cancers. So if students really believe that they have real power and continue to apply their techniques in solving important problems, then they can become Jedis like Star Wars movies. So at the end of my course, I will say to them, may the force be with you.
Perfect, perfect. That ties in perfectly. Well, thanks so much for joining us, Dr. Chen.
Thank you very much.
Thanks for being here at Notre Dame Day.